Good morning, sir. Good morning. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir.
Some CSR activities you have done.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So I was part of CSR in Oracle, and we have planned our own activities. They have given us opportunity to do that. And first thing we have done is try to establish stalls for actually disabled people. They had an institution which was making candles and pen stands. So we helped them establish stalls all across. And we visited schools and conducted festivals, like cultural festivals, to encourage students coming to government schools.
What was your budget?
Sir, I do not remember the budget right now.
Who is responsible for promoting revolution in India?
So we generally say Rajiv Gandhi has actually helped us in transforming India into a digital era. And along
with. Did he say or actually he has really done?
He's done, sir. Yes. He's done. Sorry, sir.
He's really responsible for that?
Yes, sir.
What else he has done?
So,
our present Prime Minister also sometimes says that most of the, all the Prime Ministers have contributed something for development to the country in the last 74 years or so.
Yes, sir.
So, he also would have done something very well.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me 4 or 5 major things which he has done?
Yes, sir. So first thing is the digital revolution and telecommunications. So because of that, we had telephones reaching almost rural areas and mobile communication increased. And second, communication increase, not mobile, sir, telephone communication increasing. And after that, he was also part of some technical missions on in relation to literacy or water provision, oil seas production, etc. And along with that, he was also part of some Panchayati Raj local government revolutions. Although the Panchayati Raj Act was not passed during his time, his laid framework for local governments. And so these are a few things that I can
think about. Pensions, regional pensions in
yes, sir. States. Yes, sir. So there were accords like Punjab Accord and Assam Accord that were signed during Rajiv Gandhi era, which has helped us in settling issues in these areas.
And this, you have heard IRAM's
issue? Yes, sir. So, in relation to defection of ministers. Yes, so anti-defection law was passed during Rajiv Gandhi era.
That is anti-defection, we call it
anti-defection
law or amendment to the Constitution?
So, it is an amendment to the Constitution where we've added a 10th schedule, which actually includes the rules and provisions in relation to how MP should be treated when shifting.
Something about education also in the, specifically for the rural area?
Sorry, sir. Yes, sir. So, Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya is for rural area.
You have heard of Indian Penal Code?
Yes, sir.
That provides different punishments for different crimes.
Yes, sir.
There is a crime which if you want to do it, attempt doing it, you are punished. But if you do it, there is no reason.
Sorry, sir, I'm unable to comprehend.
You understood the question?
No, sir, I'm unable to understand.
There is a crime that if you attempt to do it, you will be punished. But if you have already committed, there is no reason.
Sir, are you. Suicide is what? Yes, attempt to suicide.
Okay. Already, suicide is committed.
Yes, sir.
You can
have it.
YMCA. Heard of that?
Yes, sir. But not able to recollect exactly what its activities.
See, this recently Supreme Court has allowed entry of women in NDA.
Yes, sir.
But now, those institutions, even army, all they are telling, it's very difficult to implement. What can be the issues for implementing it?
So The main provision is right now the institutions that we're talking about, NDA and Army, they're more towards men. So in relation to movement of troops or how they are trained, etc. So I think there should be a framework or time frame provided for these institutions to include provisions in relation to women. That's why I think the institutions are asking for more time to implement.
What improvements will be required if girls are also taken at ND level? You know, ND level, what is at what age they are taken?
Yes, I don't know the exact age, but I know that it is a very young age, at around 12th after 12th class.
So what improvements will be required?
Yes, so first thing is training programs for women. So the level of difficulty might have to be different for women compared to men. And even in a combat role, we'll have to, if we have to induce women, there should be a training that is towards possible for women to get into without getting hurt or anything. And also with respect to movement of troops or placement of women, where they should be placed.
No, this is the initial training. It's not that. Advanced training
is up to ND
training is over.
Yes, sir. Infrastructure. Yes, sir. And some sensitization programs among the present soldiers.
There was an industrial accident in Vijayawada.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me about this?
Sir, the accident was actually in LG Polymers. So there was a leak of styrene gas, which happened after the company was trying to restart after a post-COVID lockdown. The styrene gas has leaked and caused the death of two or three members, and also many of them have fell unconscious.
What are the NDMA guidelines with respect to industrial accidents? Are you familiar with this?
Sir, I'm not able to recollect them right now.
Okay. Now, globally there is something called as a chip shortage.
Yes, sir.
Are you familiar with this?
Yes, sir. So,
why is there a chip shortage?
So, during COVID time, due to lockdowns, we know that chips are generally made using a global supply chain where parts are made at different places and assembled at one place. So, due to this, lockdowns and supply chain disruption in supply chain, the chips shortage has occurred right
now. Is it also because certain products sold more than expected, which consumed chips?
Yes, sir. So because of increase in digitization and work from home, etc., so there's more sale of laptops and digital devices, which actually increase the demand for chips.
So this chip shortage, global chip shortage, which industries are it going to affect?
So we have automobiles, we have mobile or laptop manufacturers, and also FMCG goods, some of them like washing machines or ACs, which actually use this digital chips. They also get affected.
A role of computers in automobiles have increased over the years.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me about this?
Sir, they're trying to make even cars as smart devices by inducing computer devices. So one thing is trying to make the maximum extent usage is autopilot, where the car drives by itself by identifying obstacles, etc. And the other one is making it easier by voice commands, by directly saying that open a door or lock a door, etc. And also the navigation system, easing the navigation system by using GPS, etc.
Are you familiar with the latest IPCC report?
Yes, sir.
What are some of the observations of the report?
So IPCC 6th report has actually highlighted a code red for humanity. So it has mentioned that we have already reached 1.1 degree centigrade rise in average temperature compared to the pre-industrial levels, and it identified that we have only roughly two decades left to reach 1.5 degree centigrade, and it has given that extreme weather events and compound weather events would increase, and there would be different impact at different locations.
What regions would be relatively less impacted by climate change?
Pardon, sir?
Which regions of the world would be relatively less of climate change?
The areas which other than the coastal regions or the glacial regions or dry regions, the extratropical regions would be less affected when compared to tropical regions.
Will there be some regions whose climate will be changed in a positive manner because of climate change?
Yes, sir. So if we take examples of hills, the slow line will actually increase. So that way we are increasing the cultivation in these regions. That is one thing. And earlier where there were dry regions, there might be an increase in rainfall in few areas. So that will actually bring some land into cultivation in those areas.
You worked as a software engineer for almost 6 years, 7 years?
5 years.
5 years, from 2011 to 16.
Yes, sir.
Every job that you have taken, you have worked for lesser and lesser duration. That's a pattern that I'm seeing. Are you done with the software engineering?
Yes, sir. So in Oracle only I have decided to come to civil services, but before coming I wanted to work for a startup. So I wanted to explore the culture. That's why.
So how was this mountain trail? Can you tell me about the other two jobs other than Oracle?
So the first one is actually an interior design company, but they wanted to better the customer relationship. So I have led a team which actually built a supply chain system and customer relation management system, where we have maintained that a timeline should be a fixed timeline for delivery of goods. So the customer need not have to reach us. There will be an automatic dashboard and reporting at higher levels, which will automatically impact, like informed if there is any delay in the process. That is the first
one. Are you aware of use of augmented reality in home decor?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me about this?
So augmented reality is actually, if you have the framework, the outline framework, using computer technology, we can show the user how their home can look with replacing through computers, digital technology. So for interior decoration, if I take example, how the colors would look, how the design would look. That is really.
What does this mountain trails put by them?
So that is actually Chai Point chains, if you know, and it is related to
which one? Chai Point.
Chai Point. Yes, okay. So it actually has two chains. One is the Chai Point outlets that they have, and second one is food delivery to businesses like corporate offices, etc. Similar to Coffee Day, like we have Coffee Day machines, etc. So there we were building an IoT enabled vending machines. The chai dispenser or a coffee dispenser or a vending where you can get.
So IoT is already active in coffee dispenser.
Yes, sir. So we have tried doing that for a single unified machine which has a better quality of tea and chai, because Chai Point has.
So how does IoT help in quality of tea?
So IoT was only for the ease of the customer. So because they wanted automated bills and they wanted to see how much is being consumed, etc. So that in a way is an addition, because they get a dashboard as such where the accountant can actually go and.
So the back end supply chain of the tea machine was also run by supplies of materials used for manufacturing tea?
Not supply manufacturing, but to check whether the machine actually needs to be replaced, the quantities needs to be replaced, or if there is a need for cleaning. So all those things was done by IoTs.
So what did you learn by working in a startup?
So first thing is, compared to a bigger corporate, a startup, you get more responsibilities. So at the lower level also, even if you're working as a software developer, you get more responsibilities. And ideas would be easily heard compared to a bigger one, because you have direct interaction with the higher levels. And you get...
So you like working in a startup better than Oracle?
Yes, sir. I actually liked working...
So you would not like working in government?
No, sir, I think...
Doesn't operate like a startup.
So I think the culture can be brought up from whatever I have learned in a startup. I think I can bring that culture and try to make some changes at wherever I get a chance to work.
Your Prasanna Chief Minister came out with a three capital scheme for Andhra Pradesh.
Yes.
How do you personally see this?
Sir, I think we already have examples where judiciary is located in a separate place. So the challenge would be executive and legislative being in different places. The idea behind this was regional development. So I think it would help in regional development, because if we see the erstwhile Andhra Pradesh, Hyderabad had higher level of development when compared to other cities in Andhra Pradesh. So I think this idea should work.
Whether it is practically possible?
So there will be initial hiccups, because we know that a legislature and an executive should be in close relation continuously. But I think there needs to be new ideas or implementation where it becomes easier for the common man.
How do you see development is linked to capital?
So capitals are generally places where we where activities take place, and we have investments coming into capitals.
Why?
because government, there's a trust among investors that government would provide facilities at these locations, the common facilities that we need, infrastructure, etc.
So, when legislature is situated somewhere, judiciary is somewhere, and executive is in three places.
Yes, sir.
So, any investor, your theory says if investor, if they invest in capital city, easy for them to manage things.
Yes, sir.
Because all the agencies will be there. If it is spread over like this,
yes, sir.
And how do you think it will attract investment?
Sir, at every location we'll have, at all these three locations, we'll have government coming up with the infrastructure like roads, power supply, etc. So that would attract investors. And at the same time, we need to use digital technologies to make sure that the interaction with agencies need not be at the location of the place. Even if you want to interact with someone in legislature, they should be able to do it from Visakhapatnam, which is the executive capital.
What are the challenges after bifurcation? What are all the big challenges faced by our village?
So the first challenge was with relation to economy, because we had a major share of economy was coming from Hyderabad city. So that is the first challenge. The second challenge is in relation to the water disputes that we have with the state of Telangana, because erstwhile it was the Krishna Godavari tribunal had distributed to Andhra Pradesh as a whole. Now we have to distribute between Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. Second, third is in relation to establishing and developing the capital from grassroots, the initial scratch level. So that is another challenge there.
How is the economic challenge, financial problem is being addressed by Andhra Pradesh?
Yes, so Andhra is working at different levels. At the industrial level, so they have released a new industrial policy last year in 2020, which included almost 10 to 12 industries, which mostly focusing on MSMEs in relation to toys, medic, pharma, etc. And along with that, they're also encouraging cottage industries and MSMEs at grassroots levels, and women SHGs are being encouraged to establish. And along with this, there's also focus on tourism industry at different locations, like Visakhapatnam or caves in Rayalaseema region, etc. So these are the things that I can think of.
Yoga, what type of yoga do you practice?
Sir, I practice Hatha Yoga, sir.
What is the meaning of Hatha Yoga?
Sir, Hatha Yoga is basically a coordination between mind and body using asanas, and it also includes other breathing exercises.
Yoga means unification of mind and body, right?
Yes, yes, sir.
What is Hatha Yoga?
Sir, Hatha Yoga is more focused on asanas and practice.
It is different from Patanjali Yoga and other type of yoga. What are the other types of yoga you are aware of?
Sir, I'm not able to recollect right now.
Hatha Yoga, you got training from Isha or?
No, sir. In Bangalore, there was another foundation, yoga school.
Okay.
There I got.
Right, geography.
Yes.
Can you ask us this year's monsoon?
So this year initially we have predicted that monsoon will be normal. We'll possibly have excess monsoon rainfall. IMD has predicted, but there's a long break that has taken place. Because of the break, the average rainfall in certain locations has reduced. But we are expecting that the monsoon revival should take place in this remaining days of August. So the average rainfall is will be normal is what predicted.
What are all the theories around Indian monsoon?
Sir, we have Kutishwaran theory and we have Ian theory, which are basically talking about the winds that are flowing in Arabian Sea and how the monsoon gets divided at the tip of India, and one branch reaching to Bay of Bengal, one branch reaching to Arabian Sea. And we also have a land and sea heating theory, which is right now not as accepted compared to the other theories.
Okay, coming back to your capital scheme, how do you see settlement theory working in the formation of the three capitals?
So settlement will not be concentrated at a single location, it will be distributed. So I think it will be mostly around these capitals, where the three proposed capitals and the pattern with respect to Visakhapatnam, because it is a hilly region, so right now the spread is restricted in few directions. But with respect to Amaravati, because it is a plain region, we'll have settlement spread across all regions. It might be a river sprawl across the transport arteries, etc. With respect to Kurnool, so sir, it is a dry region, so settlements would be spread across areas where there is water availability.
Okay, last question, Oracle.
Yes, sir.
How do you see future of Oracle in the phase of big data and artificial intelligence?
So Oracle has slowly moved into big data. It has been behind other big companies, but it is moved into it, and it is more concentrated on enterprise.
Oracle's main strength is relational database systems,
sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Does RDBMS have relevance in today's context?
Sir, there is a shift to big data, where we are talking of rather than a typical relational big data, storing it in near the computer or processing it near the computer. But Oracle has quickly shifted from RDB.
Oracle shifted, okay.
Yes,
my original question was aimed at that one. Yes, RDBMS future. RDBMS, can we say it's an outdated technology or outdated platform?
So we still have relevance because we don't have all the companies moving to big data. The movement is slow, so Oracle is concentrating.
What is the difference? We are layman.
Yes, sir.
What is the difference between big data and RDBMS?
So RDBMS is a normal storage data, where we have a database with typical restricted memory and etc. But when it comes to big data, we have flow at a very high velocity, and the data need not be stored at a single location. It can be stored at the system. The processing also on RDBMS takes place at a particular server location, but with respect to big data, the processing can happen at different locations. So the cloud computing is an example which uses big data, etc. So this is the difference.
There is no need for structured different tables. RDBMS, we go by different relational tables.
Yes, sir.
Relations between these,
yes,
tables,
sir.
No?
Yes, sir.
And big data, there is no requirement of those things. Can I say like that?
No, sir. The big data, it need not be a fixed set of tables, but we do need tables. It might differ.
With an example, just tell me an example how I can. I want to learn. How can I understand?
Yes, sir. So,
the difference. RDBMS and big data, how to comprehend the difference? Can you tell some example?
Yes, so I am taking an example of a retail chain. Retail chain, like say we have more retail chain. So if we have more, in a typical RDBMS data, what we have a table of substances that we get, the stock that we have, etc. And we have sales, which is mapped to that, we have everything is fixed. But when it is big data, what we have is we might get a single chain of data which is unprocessed. It just says, okay, so and so person X has bought 3 apples on this day. So we process this data and then form it into different places and put that, okay, this X is a customer and these are the items that I bought. And this relation, actually this chain, can form a relation which will enhance in our customer relationship later. So I know.
Okay. With respect to geography, so for a good port, what kind of geography is needed there?
So one thing is the port. For a port, you need a minimum depth for the vessels to easily come in and leave. And the weather has to be supporting it. The erratic weather would actually make it difficult in those locations. And also, if there is sedimentation, that would actually hamper these locations as a port.
Why Vizag is the most popular port? and the most important?
First thing is the locality, its access to the Southeast Asian nations, which are a major market for us. And second thing is, it is one of the major ports on the East Coast. On West Coast, we have many major ports. On East Coast, it is a major port, which caters to a huge interland, which includes states like Orissa, Andhra, Telangana, which have a good export potential. And also, the industries that are located in Visakhapatnam makes the port more important, because we need import of substances and also export of the finished goods.
Are the industries there because the port is there, or the port is there because the industries is there?
It's a mutual relationship. Initially, industries have come up because port is located. Now, port is actually enhancing the industrial development.
What is Sagar Mala initiative of Government of India?
So, Government of India has wanted to take advantage of our huge coastline and develop ports and connect them to hinterlands through multimodal transport. For that, we have chosen few major ports and few minor ports, and we're in the process of developing these ports. To there are multiple proposals by the government, which includes the industrial development, along with that the community development in these regions, because this would developing the port would actually help in jobs because of industrial development.
Okay. DAV Public School, you did your 10th from there.
Yes.
So what's the full form of DAV?
Dayanand Anglo Vedic Public School.
And who was Swami Dayanand?
So Swami Dayanand was a reformist from 18th century, and he was the founder of Arya Samaj.
Okay. And what is Arya Samaj?
Arya Samaj is which is an institution which was proposing for ban of idolatry, and it was fighting for women rights. It was also promoted education for all, and it encouraged that Vedas can be learned by anyone irrespective of their caste.
So does it also recognize as yoga?
Sorry, my mom, I'm unaware of it.
Home Vista Decor and Furnishings Limited. It was a manufacturing company. Also, there was a manufacturing also which was taking place. Or it was only interior.
It was only interior designing and finishing the projects. No, at the location.
Okay, no manufacturing.
No manufacturing.
Okay, and you mentioned that you had made a program or a software for them for the logistic purpose, the time delivery.
Yes.
And according to your view, you know, in order to be, you know, within the time frame, do you think that it's somewhere in order to honor the time, sometimes the quality is also being affected? So how do we balance between the quality and the timely delivery of the product?
Yes, ma'am. So,
a similar challenge.
Yes, ma'am. So we had this issue at Home Decor also, because we had a specific timeline for every work. If a carpenter is going for one room, there would be 2 days timeline. So with respect to this, we had placed two or three conditions. One thing is the supply material, it should be of good quality. So this was actually checked before the timeline itself starts. Then with respect to work, so as soon as the person has finished their work, one is that we have made compulsory that they should upload some pictures of their work, and also there was an immediate feedback to the customer. If they have any issues, they can raise those issues within 1 or 2 days, and that would be immediately sent to the concerned worker, and that would be taken care immediately. So these are few measures that we have taken to ensure that.
Okay, Mountain Trail Food Private Limited, that is, you just mentioned about this company. So what is this problem of plenty of food? Just came in the news also a day or 2 days back.
Sorry, I'm unaware of it.
Okay. Alexa voice. If you had to design that, would you have preferred a male voice or a female voice?
We can actually give an option of both. In the Alexa voice, no? Where the where the family.
This is. I'm asking you only on that.
I think female voice would be better.
Why female voice? Why do we have only female voices as virtual assistants?
I think female voice is more sweeter when compared to male. We have that warmth around the voice. That's why I think there's a belief that it is better to have a female voice.
So, do you think it's the right thing to do to have to encourage female voices rather than, you know, bringing in male voices, and especially for the as a virtual assistant?
Do
you see any gender bias?
Yes, ma'am. So it is kind of a similar to pink collar job that we have. So similar to that, we believe that virtual assistants generally come in female voice. But in recent times, they've actually started giving option of both male. I am unable to recollect right now, ma'am. But there was an option where you can choose which voice and which accent that you want for virtual assistant.
Okay, fine. Thank you.
Okay.